Hello everyone, Cuddles Gaming Ireland, and welcome back to War of the North gameplay. We are into episode 5, part 2. Currently, as I am recording this right now, episode 4, Stone Giants Rivendell featuring the Eagles, which I know is supposed to be kind of a part 1, but I changed my mind. That is currently changing to HD as I talk to you, so it should be premiering on my channel. The link for that is in the description down below, as is the War of the North playlist, which is also down below, as well as my social media links. So, in roughly about, I want to say in the next 10 to 20 minutes, episode 4 will be live. Episode 5, part 1, I will be editing after I've recorded this episode. So hopefully it'll be well. I can try and get episode 5 part 1 out tonight. With a view to then me sorting this one out on Friday. Because I was on a quick chat with a good friend of mine, Mike's Fight. His link's also in the description below, so check him out. You know, about content schedules and whatnot. And because he was like, well, what's your day routine? I was like, work Monday to Fridays. Finish at 4:15 on a Friday, so basically weekend. And I just said to him, what? I want to have one chill day, 3 days of doing art, 3 days of doing gaming. And he said, yeah, sounds works. So, yeah. And for some reason, I'm stuck on a bloody elf, and I don't want to be stuck on an elf. There we go. Right, okay, I've sorted that out myself though. Right, now we're gonna get going. Right,
there was a sharp skirmish here. The tracks are hard to read, but it appears the fighting carried on into the mountain.
Ooh. And is it me, or does that look a bit like a dwarven door? Oh, hello, what's that over there? I think we're going in, guys. Mount Gundabad, Alfheim Pass. So essentially, I'm concluding episode 5, part 1, right now. So this is going to get edited and put at the end of part 1. So the next time you see will be when I'm inside. Hope that all makes sense to you.
Nordenbad.
He can't tell us anything more. He's gone.
But there may be more like him within this fortress.
Mm.
Yes. They're searching for some sort of weapon. Come, we must try to find them.
It pains me to leave fallen dwarves to these accursed orcs, but we have no choice.
So we're now going into the mountain. Hmm. What the hell? Okay. I don't know, just for once, could you not draw their attention? Okay, this is where I need to get healed. Where's that one coming from? Oh, you little shitbag. Right, he's gone. Are we good to go? Yeah, we are. Oh, fuck off, you knob. That's good. You gone? Bloody eight goblins are a pain in the ass. Oh shit. What's up here? Chest. Right, now once we go. Funnily enough, beforehand, I never got to this stage of the game, so I have no idea where I'm at. Oh, things are falling.
To have long lives.
I am in your debt.
Ranger, there are still foes to defeat.
I was sure I'd met my end. It's good to be wrong.
Ready.
weapons and armor to equip the Horde's gathering.
They're making more than that. Can't you smell it? The same blasting powder used against us at Fornost. There must be a huge store of it here.
Then let us destroy the gears. Perhaps we will slow their war mills.
Let's update those arrows. Oh, no, skill points we've got. Increases number, increases that was a bow attack. Okay, cool. Right, what else we got going on? Ooh, nice. Like those. Got a brand new arrow. Drop that because it's not that great. That's what I've got at the minute, and that's probably my best sword to use. Yeah. Hold on. Right, that's them changed. That's all good to go. Right, I just think, okay, because I reckon there's something along this. Come on, you bastards. Right, that's him dealt with.
Face a Dunedain now!
So... how the fuck did we get a... oh no, hang on, we come across there, got over it, where do we go? I don't know where I'm going now. Right, which way have I just come from? I imagine it's that way, so... ah, there we go. Right, now we're good to go. Right, so this is... Do you want to return to Riverdale? No, not really. No, no, I don't want to return to Riverdale. Ah, I've got to get all of his scrolls. Okay. Okay, so there's a few things I have got to go back to Rivendell for, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to go back to Rivendell, and then I'm going to go back again. Where's Arwen? Right, okay, there's Arwen, so I've got to give her this potion stuff.
It is good to see you safely returned to Imladris and seemingly untouched in battle.
It feels weird, Liv Tyler not voicing Arwen.
I am pleased to be back. I have brought you the items you requested from the Ettenmoors.
Thank you. You have brought these in good time, for we have made barely enough Miravor for present need, and now there is none to spare. With these supplies, I can replace what has been given away, and as I promised, I have kept aside a flask for you. Miravor is potent. Thus, I would advise you to keep this against a time when you're sorely hurt and your strength of will falters. Drink of it then, and you will be restored.
Thank you, Lady Arwen. When such a time comes, I will remember your generosity. Is there something amiss, Lady Arwen? It would seem that something troubles you. Is there a way I may help?
You have done much already, but I will lay my problem before you. For many years, I have worked secretly upon a banner for Estelle, for Aragorn. It is my hope he will bear it triumphantly into Gondor, and the time is right for him to reclaim his heritage. This must be a banner like no other, and must endure for the ages. To that end, I am using the most precious of metals, Mithril.
Mithril? Oh, never mention of it. She's also using the Hobbit. For me.
The embroidery is nearly done, but as careful as I have been, I fear what I have may not be enough to complete the design.
But Mithril can only be found in the mines of Moria, a distant and perilous place by all accounts. Unless you know of anywhere else we might find it.
It is true. There is nowhere in Middle-earth where Mithril might still be mined other than Moria. Yet in ages past, quantities of this precious metal made their way by trade and gift to many other places in the world.
Yes, if the stories are true, the guardsmen of the Citadel in distant Minas Tirith wear helms of Mithril.
Still, it seems there is little hope that more Mithril can be found in so short a time. What exists in the world is likely considered too precious to part with.
It seems my fate to travel far and frequently. What cannot be obtained in peace may sometimes be seized as spoils of war. For the sake of my captain and future king, any Mithril I find shall be yours.
That is a noble offer. I would not ask you to go into such danger for this alone, for it may yet prove that I already have all that I require. Still, it would ease my mind, and I would see that you were well rewarded for your courage and generosity. May Elbereth watch over you and keep you safe.
So that's that quest completed. Now, who was I going to again? Oh, so I was going to Elven for something. I can't think what the bloody hell it was. Hang on, I've got to get some repairs done.
Hello again. What can I help you with?
Is there anything else that needs repairing? Them and I think these. There we go. Right, all sorted. Right, now I'm going to see Elrond really quickly, and I'm emphasis on the word quick.
Is there something I can help you with, Eridan?
I found this tome hidden amid the ruins at Fornost. It appears to be quite old.
This seems to be a work by the men of Arthedain. It may well have been written before the destruction of Fornost.
The pages are too worn and the writing too faded for me to make out much. Perhaps you can discover more.
Indeed. It seems to be a personal journal. And here is a name inscribed. M-A-L. Why, this appears to be a work of Malbeth, the seer of Arthedain.
Tell me about this realm of Arthedain.
Arthedain was the last fragment of the great northern kingdom of Arnor. The heirs of Isildur ruled as kings of Arthedain until it too was destroyed by the enemy.
Yet the line of kings has remained unbroken. This much I know well.
It is true Isildur's line has remained unbroken. But without a kingdom to rule, they have not claimed the title of king, and have been known simply as chieftains of the Dúnedain. It is our friend Aragorn who currently bears that title, although he will be the last to do so. Either he will become a king, or Isildur's line will come to an end with him.
I will leave you to your work.
Right, so that's everything I need to do, and now I'm going to get back to... where I need to go, which is back to Mount Gundabad. Right then. Help the dwarves defeat the attacking orcs. Christ. Oh, lovely. Goblins. Just what you want in a mine. Oh, fuck off.
You face a ranger now.
Thank you, my friend. I'm in your debt.
Damn it. Come on. What the fuck's that? Right, carrying on. Right, here we go. Oh, fuck off. What the hell? He just exploded. What the hell was that? Right. Oh, yes. Now we're talking. That's less damage than that. So I'm sticking with that sword. Oh, I noticed it was a bit more on. Oh. Nah, keeping that as it is. Oh, that's a lovely sight, isn't it? Oh, God. Gundabad Mountains interior. Done. Ooh, cutscene. I've gone past the crossbow.
Sure, I met my end.
good to be wrong.
I don't know what brings you to a place like this, but I'm mighty glad to see you all the same.
We might say exactly the same. What are you doing here?
We've come to activate an ancient weapon. With luck, it'll kill a lot of orcs.
What sort of weapon?
You'll see. Once activated, it'll take some time to do its work.
Aye, and it's sure to bring a lot more orcs down on us, too.
No time for dilly-dallying. Go ahead and use it.
We'll hold off the orcs.
A horn call? Are you mad? You're calling them here.
I did warn you about that.
Literally, it's just disappeared. That's one dead. Got the second one. I'm up to it. It's better than that. Bloody Orkai. Can't see anymore. Oh, hold on. So I'm going down to finish the job myself. Come on, die already. Oh shit, trolls, bollocks. Come on, come on! Come on, come on, come on. Okay, that's complete. Right, what's this weapon supposed to be doing? What? Thank you. That's the weapon. Oh.
The whole mountain is coming down!
Aye, a good deal of it anyway. Just as we hoped.
You knew this was going to happen?
It's what we came here for.
We had to strike this blow if our people are to survive. I'm heartily sorry for getting all of you killed as well.
I don't think we need to worry about death just yet. Look!
Durin's beard!
Hey, it's the Eagles! There we go.
Well, this is a day I'll not soon forget. I've seen a few things in my time, but I've not flown on an eagle's back till today.
Well, now that it's a bit easier to talk, let me thank you properly for saving our lives and bid you welcome to Norinbad, our home.
Notary's father, the Lord Goran, will want to speak with you. Notary's gone ahead to report on the Gundabad raid and to tell him about everything you did for us.
Okay, this is where I am going to leave it right now. So, yeah, that is, I would have to say, the Mount Gundabad episode done, episode 5. So, this is going to get edited on Friday. And probably uploaded on the Friday evening as well, because I'm going back home on Saturday, just for the day. So, with that in mind, keep an eye out on tweets and me Insta for socials, still with the links down below. I've been Cosmo907, until next time, peace!